Good evening, Excellency, Coordinating Minister for Politics, Legal and Security Affairs, Pak Luhut Pandjaitan, ambassadors, fellow alumni, ladies and gentlemen. It is a great pleasure to welcome all of you here tonight. As President of the UNSW Alumni in Indonesia, I would like to extend a special welcome to our guests from our university, President and Vice Chancellor Professor Ian Jacobs, and all the delegation from our university. I think we really like to give special thanks to Pak Luhut Pandjaitan, who actually today make all the effort to be here. He flew from Ambon, Bali, Jogja, to be with us in Jakarta on the same day. So let's give a hand. My thanks also go to the foreign policy community of Indonesia, Dr. Dino Patijalal, our valued partner in organizing tonight's event, and all the students and lecturers who are here tonight. The theme for tonight's discussion is pro-business. What does the government mean by it, and what does the business community want? This is going to be a very interesting discussion. Not to mention timely and extremely relevant, in many parts of the world, the term pro-business has become conventional and commonplace. But in Indonesia, it is something relatively new. This used to be a time, not too long ago, when politician or government official would refrain from uttering the term pro-business. There was widely held notion that being pro-business did not mean pro-people or pro-poor. There was something elitist about the term pro-business, something not right. It is as if you had to choose either you are pro-business or pro-people. Well, that has begun to change now. As we could see in the last election, political and candidates for office more and more spoke about the need for the government and for Indonesian people to be pro-business. Being pro-business is increasingly seen as something good, something positive, and this is the way it should be. Today, being pro-business means also pro-people and also pro-poor. This is because without doubt that it is the private sector that will create jobs, more so than other entity. It is the private sector that will generate economic activities, set new business, spur production, promote innovation, and create wealth for the nation. The job for the government is to create the necessary climate that would enable businesses to grow and prosper. I truly believe, as I am sure in many of this room also, that the government's ability to enact serious pro-business strategy will be one of the most critical game changers for the economic policy of our Jokowi administration. Tonight, I'm very pleased that we have been graced by the presence of excellent list of speakers. My job tonight is the hardest one. Aside from welcoming you, is also to introduce our Coordinating Minister for Politics, Legal and Security Affairs, retired general, Pak Luhut is four-star general, and successful businessman, Pak Luhut Pandjaitan, has kindly taken the time in his busy schedule to be with us tonight. Pak Luhut is certainly one of the most prominent members of the present cabinet. He has the trust of our president. In his previous position as a chief of staff to the president, Pak Luhut has built reputation to be a bulldozer. Someone who is always on his feet, always looking for solution, and always willing to break down a few doors where necessary. Pak Luhut is someone who likes to think outside the box. A number of the government's key policy decisions, including in economic and business, were suggested and pushed through by way of Pak Luhut's efforts. So now I have the great pleasure to invite our Coordinating Minister Pak Luhut to deliver his message to us. Let's give him our warm appreciation.